Sister Sol, on track to serve a million meals by the end of the year. That's all ahead on Here and Now. Food insecurity is one of the persistent issues exacerbated by the pandemic. And Brotherhood Sister Sol, a Harlem-based nonprofit, pitched in to help. And BroSis is on track to serve a million meals by the end of the year. Here today to tell us more is the co-founder and executive director, Kari Lazar White. Thank you so much for being with us this afternoon.
Thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure to be with you.
You know, I always love talking to you, and I love talking to you about the work that you do with the young people. And we're even more impressed with the fact that you guys, during this pandemic, really went to work in the community. Talk to me a little bit about these meals that you've been able to provide.
Well, Brotherhood Sister Sol is a comprehensive youth development organization that works in the space of educating, organizing, and training. And from our beginning, 26 years ago, we've always prided ourselves in responding to community needs, supporting community. We are the community. We are part of the community. And so when COVID hit at the height of the pandemic last March and April and May, when the city was really in a place of terror and was shut down, we asked our young people, what did they need most intensely in their life? And they needed access to technology, and we provided computers and laptops and hotspots. They needed financial support, and we helped pay critical bills. And then they spoke really powerfully about food insecurity and their need for food access. And so that first week when the city was completely shut down in March, our brave staff stepped up and provided food and served our young people, the children of our organization. But as we did that, the general community came out and also expressed deep food insecurity and need for support. And so what started as a small effort to support our young people has now grown to over 60 straight weeks of providing food, and we provided over 700,000 meals in the Harlem community since last March.
Which is incredible. And how were you able to do this?
Well, first, I think, again, we were a place that gets the job done. That is an organization that's just deeply committed to community and to our people. First, we rented U-Haul trucks and drove to wholesalers and filled up our trucks with food that we purchased. And our staff and our alumni and our board broke down that food into bags of groceries. This isn't about serving one hot meal. This is providing a family with enough food for a week to feed a family of four. As we began to do that work, we started to develop partners, and we're very proud to partner with Grow NYC and Corbin Hill, both of whom provide fresh produce to us. But overwhelmingly, we're purchasing the food, we're raising the funds to do it, we're staffing the need for it, and every single Wednesday, we're distributing food to our community.
You know, responding to the pandemic and the way that you guys have responded to the pandemic, has it at all shifted, the overall focus of the organization, or has this sort of fall in line with what you've always been teaching?
Well, the reason that the Brotherhood Sister Sol works in these three interconnected spaces of educating, training, and organizing is that, yes, we're trying to help young people every single day to build the skills they need to be successful. But we're also helping young people question the society they were born into. We're very open about talking about racial inequality and income inequality. And so the reality is our young people were facing substandard schools, in most cases, poor housing and insufficient food and health care pre the pandemic. The pandemic cracked something open. It was already there. Already one third of all New Yorkers live in poverty or near the poverty line. And so those realities were there. The pandemic deepened something. It made something worse. And so what our response was what it's always been, to step up, to serve, to hold hands with our community, and to be there in support, in guidance, and also provide, this really basic and needed necessities.
And just, you've worked with so many people over such a long period of time. The last year has been, I would think, God, such a teaching moment. You just mentioned it, all the things that you always talk about, they've kind of been under the surface, but the truth of the matter is people are living them, and they're living them out in the open now. Talk to me a little bit about how you think that this will affect some of the young people that you work with every day as we move forward and out of this. Maybe, even in terms of, what they may see as their future role in the community, what work they want to do, or anything, along those lines.
Well, Brotherhood Sister Sol proudly identifies as a social justice organization. And I think one of the interesting realities of the last year and a half is that, you know, if 2 years ago you said to our young people, you know, what are the greatest challenges that you face, they would have talked about racial and economic inequality. Mm-hmm. And what's happened over the last year, two of the dominant national conversations are about racial and economic inequality. The killing of George Floyd that led to the largest protest this nation mm-hmm. has ever seen. COVID, which of course is a public health issue, but we know disproportionately affects low-income Black and brown people. And so it's interconnected with income inequality and racial inequality. So now these two national conversations, these storms, if you will, these pandemics yeah. of different kinds, we're really in the center of. And I think for our young people, it's been eye-opening, the role of young people in both articulating a different vision for the future of this country around racial equality and equity, but also our young people not just receiving the food we distribute, but our young people and alumni helping to distribute the food themselves, being involved in service and service to their community, but identifying why the need is so extreme. Every day that we deliver this food and we pass it out, you know, it's a sobering day. On one level, we feel deeply affirmed that we are helping so many in our community. But it's also a day of sadness because the need is so extensive in our community. And that is allowed to happen in, you know, the wealthiest city and the wealthiest nation in the country. And so, I mean, in the world. And so, you know, that's something that we're often talking with our young people about.
Yeah, I know. I think a lot of us are shaking our heads and wondering how did we get to here? I wanted to give you a chance to talk about some of the things you're doing to, you know, even help you do more of the great work that you've been doing over the last decades in Harlem. Talk to us a little bit about that great building, this beautiful building that's going up.
Brotherhood Sister Sol is, you know, a citywide organization. We work in schools in different boroughs, and we work on policy issues that are around criminal justice, racial justice, economic justice, gender justice. But our physical location is based in Harlem. We're proud to come from one of the most famous neighborhoods in the world, in the historic community of Harlem. And on 143rd Street, we're building a 20,000 square foot state-of-the-art building. It is a building that will house nothing but our operations to organize, to educate, and to train. We are so excited to build a building that's about the enrichment and enlightenment of children. It is a beautiful space, which they deserve, with cutting-edge technology and food systems, you know, connected, and farmers market that we'll be able to support. We'll be having spaces for counseling and art programming. It's really, I think, a game changer, you know, for the field of youth development. And we believe that our young people deserve that kind of beauty, that kind of structure in their life. And, you know, we say we're building a beacon for our young people, for our community. We're just so excited that we'll be complete this October.
And congratulations to you. And
you.
One last question before I let you go. You know, you started this adventure and watching young people respond and watching your organization rev things up. You, as I said earlier, a million meals for sure, probably surpassing that by the end of the year. Personally, what does it mean to you to see what you started in action and you're accomplishing those things and teaching young people the way that you envisioned?
Well, I think one of the things that, you know, I'm most proud of is the fact that the majority of our staff are alumni of the organization. They're men and women who went through the program as boys and girls, and we mentored and supported, and now they've returned as men and women to guide the next generation. I co-founded this organization with Jason Warwin, my childhood friend. We grew up together. We set out to create a formed community, a place that supported young people with positivity, sense of community, knowledge, and future. And so every day to see the manifestation of that leaves me feeling very proud. It's certainly a time of growth. To see the building rising is deeply affirming, deeply affecting, means a tremendous amount to me, and I think means a tremendous amount to our entire BroSis community.
Well, we appreciate everything that you do. And I want to send folks to Brotherhood, sistersoul.org to find out more information about the organization, the great work that you do, and perhaps how they can be involved.
Absolutely.
Gary Lazar-White, as usual, it is a pleasure to talk to you.
Wonderful to talk with you as well. Thanks for having me. Sandra Bookman.